once more that he stays a bit more supple during the transition. Think about preparing a new flexion before you move him over. Good boy. Little collection in it still. Little more collection, and it doesn't rush. Good. Activity in the collection, don't let it get slow behind. He sits plenty just in the normal canter. Doesn't need to sit more. Just don't want to slowing the hind leg.
Expressive, but I'm not adding too much tension in his back.
Exactly.
Exactly. He has got this great swinging expression, and then you'll see it gets a little strong, you know? So you have to say to yourself, you have to make that a little lighter all the time.
Okay.
Because also I'm sure you go in the test and say, well, that's not as big as he could do it.
Yeah.
Because there's a little tension. So you have to be able to make him a little more supple, a little more relaxed. But relax not in a way like he's never going to fall asleep. You can tell he's a little hot, actually.
Yeah.
Which again, like you look at him stand there and you're like, that's not a hot horse. And then you'll see him go and you go, oh yeah, that is a hot horse.
Yeah.
Play a little through that, and you like again, you stick to your program, and you say, now I would do canter, or yeah, I want to really see where I make the trot.
Usually go to canter first.
Perfect. And then let's, since you said you wanted to work on the pirouettes a little bit, let's do that first. That takes probably the most power.
Yes.
So do it a little early, you know, if you're not doing pirouettes after 45 minutes of riding. And again, address it how you normally would, okay? And then we'll see, I want to see the mechanics, I want to see what he does. Do not be afraid of a mistake. Mistakes are going to happen. However you normally would do it. If you spiral in, if you go right down the center line. That's my bad. I just want to see how you mechanically does it. You hit in your leg. What you felt there in the lack of whatever enthusiasm or impulsion, you lean in. So make sure your inner leg is keeping upright, upright, upright. I think that's good. But that's it. I want you to, next time you do a pirouette, do a quarter pirouette, keep the collection, one stride without turning a little out, and then another quarter, and then one stride without turning. So come a little out, not even that much out. You have to maintain the pirouette canter, and now the inner leg is straight as stride and turn again. See how he lurches, huh? Good, good. And a little out, and a little in. Yeah, good, good. And a little out, good boy. Good job. Now a full pirouette. With the thought that if he gives you any leaning in, you're gonna come a little out. And a full pirouette thinking, I have to have such control. In your leg and half up back and make it small. Half up back. Yes. Good. Good boy. Oh, good. That's a very appealing that way, you know?
Okay.
Very nice. You can have a little walk friend, you can change direction. And the next time you do a walk transition, go back to that canter to make it go smooth.
Okay.
Just think about that transition, what would that sport that had to halt, you know? And you don't want to flop your arms. That's a little long again and put him back together again. Get picky with those little things. Like when you engage them over there before the right knee, you did a couple half steps, you like walk one side and canter. Just think about walking a little longer, making sure those transitions and those preparations and when you put him back together. All that stuff is the difference between your 58 and your 60. You know what I mean? Those little things. Good. That he doesn't lose those precious points because he's not gonna trot for a 10, you know? And he's gonna make little mistakes while he learns. But the little stuff, you know, like that, now wait longer. Collect the walk, put him a little more together. Make the walk score a little higher by just positioning him correct. Yeah, yeah. Oh, you still think that's a big mistake, what's happening. You went from, okay, 7 collected walk to, 5.5, you know? Good, good. Then canter, and there can be no variation. Take time, good. Very good. Go back to the exercise with your little quarter pirouette, a little out, a little back in. Your goal is to be able to get in and out of the pirouette anytime you want. Left leg. Not forward. Not forward. Staying in the collection. More transition. Good. And little turn. We could get out of your way. Don't think you have to go around us. Good. Back in. Only one stride out. Two stride out. Yeah. Good. That it's less schooling and more working. Good. Good. Risk that there could be a mistake, and how are you going to fix it? Full pirouette small. On the foot canter. Don't panic. Feels good. And now a little up. Don't die. And little up. Flush. Jump to the calf. Good for you. Full pirouette again. Smaller. Keep your leg into the hop. Good boy. Yeah. Save it. And right back in. Please practice those. He was just about to do a perfect one and there's a little mistake, you know? And it's not like this person. He can sit like crazy. He's getting more coordinated. Good. So that's on your inner leg. Good job. Out. Good job. Very good. Supple a little through. Good boy. Come back really on the spot and then walk. Left. On the spot. And let it. Very good. Keep the walk. Good. Then he doesn't rush in the collective walk. It's a big score for him. That's good. Do you hear that walk? Now let it long for a minute. Good. That's it. Don't be afraid to do pirouettes, you know? Think about it this way. For the horses, if it's easier at the show than it is at home, they do better. So if every day, you know what, you do three pirouettes, and then at the show you go, it's funny.
Yeah.
And you go, thank God that's so much easier. It's the same thing at the opposite side. At the moment, our horses, they do like 50 yachts, and then come out. And by the time you go to the show, they're like, that was easy.
Yeah.
You know, like they want to do it. You know, I mean, okay, I get really hot horses too, so they want to do 50 steps anyway. But even the lazy ones have to do a lot of steps, and then if you say, oh, okay, a little less strides, they usually go a little bigger. How is he with the piazza?
Pretty good.
Yeah?
In the piaf, he gets a little bit, he's too active behind and not active enough in front, so I've been playing with bringing the passage back for a moment and then going forward for a moment.
Super. We can let him walk a little longer to let this thing out.
Okay.
To do the hard stuff first.
Okay.
And then they can go to the 10-feet changes because that doesn't take a lot of power. That would take endurance. But he's better at the passage and start with that, huh? So you can trot passage, walk passage. I don't want to change every little thing just because I think it should be done
okay.
A certain way, you know? I want you guys to do your thing and then I just reinforce that. Especially the first time we worked together. Make him supple up there. Good for you. Good for you. You can give even more subtle in the rein contact. You don't have to push the hand that forward because then you have to reconnect, huh? So give a little often. Take your time until you're ready. Yeah. Little more collected for the show ring. That's a good timing. He's not allowed to fall on the forehand and the passage. Good for you. Take your time. A little haunches over to the left. Right leg a little back when it gets irregular behind. There's totally regular. Keep the haunches slightly positioned left. Good for you. And make him light up there.
Good, good. Good boy. Okay. And when you're ready, then you transition into piaf, and then I want to see what it looks like first. Keep the arches slightly positioned left. You're feeling good to the right, huh? Then he tries to do everything on the right hind. Good for you. Good, stick to it. Very good. Good boy. Keep the haunches a little positioned left again. Good. Almost sat down too far. Good job. Good job. Carefully out. You see, it lurches a little again out, huh? So in that passage, piaf passage transition, find the half step. I like when you said, I like to try to get him passaging almost on the spot. That can be a half step for him. And back in again. Playing with it back and forth. Get all the way into the piaf. Don't let him lurch his way out of there. In the piaf, you stick to it a little longer. And piaf, bring him back, take the wrist, take the wrist. Patient, a little more on the spot. Good boy, good boy. Cup, cup. I agree. Stick to it. Right back to piaf. Good, talk to him. Good boy. Ho-ho. Back again. Have him sit in the piaf now a little longer. Good in the foot out. And have the feeling in a little back and on the spot. Good. Close the leg a little on. Don't jerk him, don't get him so out of there. When he quits on you, make the correction, but you want to stay in piaf, yeah? Make sure when you make corrections, you want the horse to get better. Good, excellent. Carefully out. Back in, and repeat the transition. He has to think passage on the spot. Think passage on the spot. Good, that was a great correction. And careful, careful. Still good. Take time, very good. Ho-ho-ho. Keep a little correction to it, that's right. Good, walk and praise him for that little breather for a moment. Good job, good. That's a big thing. If he halts, yeah, get after him. But you want to get after the horses in a way where you go, it gets better. You know what I mean by that, huh?
Yeah, I feel him get, if you get sticky or kind of dull, I can, overcorrect a little bit, and then he
explodes a little on you, yeah. And then we're gonna do it again, and I wanna see if he gets a little, like you said, a little sticky, a little dull, if you can turn him a little bit. It's good for a horse like this to practice a little piaf pirouette. On my big horse is a little like this. I start my piaf a little diagonally into the corner in the Grand Prix. I go like this. I go piaf over here, and then I turn him a little, and I go, okay, passage out. And when I passage out left, he's already turned a little bit. But if I keep him dead straight like that, he usually makes a mistake. He usually takes a little walk break. Let's see him this way a little bit. I like almost think like he could go a little on the forehand to come out of the piaf, okay? That he thinks of it a little easier because he gets a little hollow when he comes so high out of it, you know? That's when he lurches. So think like you're saying, here, just drop a little forward, and then you say, oh, he puts up. Good for you. That's okay. You want to make it better. Sit. And a little tap, tap, tap. Good. Good for you. That I like the patience. Good. Now you can get after, but you're wanting to get better. Sit. Good. See, that lasted half the time, though, because you're thinking, I cannot let him get out away from me. Takes a half a walk stride, bring him back again. Take passage on the spot, and transition piaf. Good. Take passage on the spot. Don't think too forward. Let it drop a little. Yeah. Good. And careful out.
And powerful. He's so good, still good. Have good timing. That was good. That's what you're gonna really practice, because he still gets you in your lower back, huh?
Yeah.
Do it once or twice more. Think passage on the spot, on the spot, on the spot, and transition piaf. And I know what you're gonna say next. You're gonna say, when I carefully come out, I feel like I'm a little stuck.
Yeah.
Live with it.
Yeah.
It's 15 strides, start at 10. Yeah, good. Careful out. He's still good? Still good? Yeah? Yeah, good save. Then he wanted to really lurch there. Think passage on the spot. That's how he's got to learn the transition. Yeah, I agree. Yeah, it's like him. Oh, good. Yeah, good. Yeah. And out. Careful. Good. Let him drop. Now say, okay, passage. And half a good for you. Half of that, collect that a little more. I got a little too forward, huh?
Yeah.
Couple him a little through again. Collect it a little more. Collect it a little more. Back, back. Good, good, good. And the transition again. Couple half steps this time, just little. Back, okay, and out. Good, half of that. Good work. Good job. Good. Little walk break for that. Great. Yeah, you're just gonna have to, it's good to do it like this on a circle.
Okay.
You know, not always like the Grand Prix or like the I2. It's good that they just have to practice and practice and practice, you know? It's good, now you kept them in the Piaf. The Piaf is fine like that. It doesn't have to go higher in the front.
Okay.
It's regular, it's good timing, it has to learn to come back more, and that's it, you know?
Okay.
He doesn't, it's actually, he sits real well. I thought I was gonna see this, you know, where they lean on and then just go like that behind, and then they go, yeah. And what needs to get better and better is that transition. Yeah? And I like when he goes a little like this, and you go, okay, now passage.
Okay.
He's got to learn to transition in between this way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in that sense, because he sits sometimes so far, right, that you feel like you're going to topple over backwards.
Yes. Yeah.
When you feel that he used to go a little on the forehand, but he's already so much sitting, you know, and it's fine. If he wasn't sitting at all, he would never say that, but he's sitting so much, you can stand to go a little forward and down.
Much and he maybe gets a little panicky, or and then I go in the test, if I go across the diagonal for my extension, it's like
it
rips me out.
He goes, here's my chance to get away from her.
Yeah, and the tempies, you know, especially the ones, I just need to get my time. If my timing's perfect, he's fine. He doesn't.
Really?
Yeah,
great.
He's fine. It's just I haven't developed the neurons to be fast and coordinated.
It's a tough thing. It took me forever. I used to ride with Johnny Blake when I learned them, and he would go,
what the heck is wrong with you?
I'm sorry, I don't know what I'm doing. Where would you rather go? You want to go to the tempies next and do a little trotting at the end? You want to trot now? The same, you know, address them like you normally would. If you do fours, threes, twos, or if you say, no, I can just go right to it. I have to just see a little first, okay? I love how subtle your aid is, and sometimes he's not going to respond because it's so little.
Yeah.
Good. Good.
Good mechanics on the chains, very nice. But think when you start one ten-piece, he's got a fairly large swinging chain. Gotta make him a little smaller. You want it to be easy for him when he learns. And again, you do those wherever you normally would, okay? Good for you. Good for you, good timing. Try not to push him too forward in the corrections, okay? He's forward enough. Maintain some degree of collection, even in the one tempi. Good. Good for you. That's what I mean. So every quote unquote error you have, good job. Pretty legged, you can barely see it move. Every quote unquote error you have, he lurches like that, you know?
Yeah.
Keep him a little rounder, a little softer. Keep asking, you got it. Good. Excellent. Very nice. The longer it was going on, the more tipped forward and tight you got, okay? He's doing a lot of them actually for you. So just go along a little bit, clock, not too forward. Not too forward, yeah. Keep clocking a little. Excellent. Very good. Well, I can really pet him for that. Good. You have to just, the one tempies are that way. Horses do one tempies. Everything else we have to cue, you know? But the best way to do ones is that the horse goes, oh, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, and just skip along, you know? And then you can do them anywhere. That was super. I like the whole system. I want to change a thing with that.
Okay.
You go one, 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 and he goes, oh, okay, I can do more. It's a perfect way for them to learn. And then, you know, like over there, he started without you,
yeah.
And you were good enough to go, okay, one, 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 and that's when he was like, oh, a bunch of them, I got it.
Yeah.
That's perfect. Okay. That's the way to do it. Awesome, now we have enough time to trot after a little break. Very, very good. And it's so good to do them on the rail for a while.
Yes.
Because that'll help, that'll keep them straight. It's really good. Exactly where you are right now. I was there too. And it's the same principle that we just talked about with the one tempi. You have to get to that point where he does a little for you. You put it back together and then you get, I want to see, you know, where you're going to go and just go a circle or straight right now. Where is your cadence trot? He's very good at passage, so have some of it, good. Have some passage tendency in there. Just don't let him get slow behind. And inch rounder, a little softer, and a little cadence up again, a little more activity. A little quicker activity. Yep, good. There is, to me, that's the trot. And that's the minimum trot. Good, good. Half halt, that's sit a little stronger. Don't let him push you out of the saddle. Good, good, school a half pass across. Does not have to be steep the first one. That gets a little flat on you over C. Keep a degree of cadence, half halt. More expression, there, there. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Good, good. Fine, don't let him get a little quick and choppy. Keep the expression. Yeah, there, that's your trot. That's a collected trot.
Good. Very good. Next time, go across the arena and make it a little steeper. Like thinking towards a Grand Prix half pass. This arena is wide though, okay?
Keep a degree of collection. One, two. Good boy.
Little half a little steeper. Left hind over. Keep going. Good. Well done. Not more. That's the expression you need. A little cadence up again. Not that it gets flat. Straight ahead. Yeah. Good. It's got to stay right there, okay? Not more forward and not flatter. That's right there. That looks more manageable, too. If you go past that, you're on his good graces, and that won't last forever, you know? Good schooling the half pass. Think of the passage. You see how it gets a little quick and flat? There. Good. Keep going. Half out, inner leg. Uh-huh. Good. Very good. Half pass zigzag when you're ready. No spooking. You go half pass right 5 meters, half pass left 10 meters, half pass right. Well, there's no spooky. Take time, get your trot back. Take passage now, make them do something. Passage, good girl. Good. Half pass right 5 meters, half off, take passage. Good, shoulder forward left. And have that over. Good. And 5 meters, fit it in. Good, changes of bend. Yeah, nice. That's your drawing. Good. One extension when you're ready. You can see the difference. Collection still. That's a girl. Super job. It looks really good.
Thank you.
It's really impressive from his confirmation and all that how good he actually is. It's super. Yeah, that's great. Get those pirouettes really good because that score is high. Those transitions, the 10-feet changes are great. You're going to love those because he looks like he would do 10-feet changes tense. That type of horse does 10-feet changes like, and he goes like, la, 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 la. It's really nice, you know? The things where they want to see relaxation, he's real good with. Awesome.
Thank you
very much. Very good, good job. You're a good boy.
Yes.
You're a good boy. Love that, that's very cool.